Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So I've been meaning to make this video for a while now. It's a video to get into the settings for your IS250, your IS350, your ISF, or just any newer Lexus vehicle and change the options that they let you change, especially like things like DRL and programming your TPMS sensor. To do this, you actually need Techstream software on your PC. If you don't have that software, it's a simple Google search and you could probably find a way to get it. So stay tuned. So the software is pretty easy to use. You have to actually plug it up to your car using a USB into your OBD2 down there, and you plug it into your computer. And once you plug it in, you run the software and you connect. So I'm already connected because I'm doing other stuff right now and monitoring the car. But you go in here and then you check all the systems that the car has. So there's gonna be a bunch of different systems. What you wanna go into is actually customize settings, which is that right there, customize settings. And that's gonna show you all the settings that you can do on this car. All right, so we're in here now. I've got a screen grab for you guys to see, but over here you can see the wireless door locks, security, wipers, warning, air conditioning, display, smart key. So in here, lighting control is where you wanna go. You could have the option to turn on and off the DRLs. This is what keeps those high beams on, especially when you got the VLANs or any other aftermarket headlight, and it's usually blinking, doing something like that because of the LEDs in there now. So you have to go in here and actually turn this off. So once you're in here, you'll see all the different settings for sensitivity, a light delay, DRL function on and off. That's the main one you wanna turn off in order to turn those DRLs off right there. Some of these other ones I've actually shown on a previous video, the door lock stuff and all that. If you wanna check out that, check out the link up above right now if you wanna check that video on doing that. But other than that, all the customizable settings that are in here that you were able to change back when you bought the car new, and the dealer would do it one time for you for free. For the tire pressure monitoring system, you go over here to the chassis, you click onto that tire pressure monitoring, and it'll bring up the utility that lets you actually change or program new sensors to your car. So you have to go under utility. The one thing that I notice on this is if you end up just programming one sensor, you have to have all your sensors. Go under register ID or ID registration. You have to actually have all four of your sensors on hand to program it. I don't want to go through this right now, but this is how you do it. You go through all the steps and you program it. But under data list, it'll list all the sensors that are already programmed to your car. You usually want to take a snapshot of that or a screen grab and print that out for your own records for later. We'll show you right here because I have both of my sensors programmed to this car already. So this car allows two sets of sensors and I have them both used. So right now we're in the data list and it actually shows my active sensors right now. I'm actually on my main sensors for my rims. I actually have my stock sensors on my stock wheels programmed as a second set on here. The second set only shows up in the data list if you actually toggle to the second set instead of the main set. Hey guys, thanks for joining me on this quick video on showing you how to change your lighting settings for the DRLs and all, and a few of the custom settings in Techstream. If you guys found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Remember guys, for all these different projects, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching and I'll talk to you guys next time.